Israel, it's your brother King Judah, giving all praise to the Most High Yah, in faith in Yahshua HaMashiach. To my Israelite family worldwide, I say peace and blessings. The title of my lesson today, I will take you one of a city and two of a family, and I will bring you to Zion. So behold your king, Israel, he's coming. Let's get it.
Bittersweet memories, painful thoughts in my head, bittersweet memories. When I was locked in that cell, pray for my enemies. Used to be off with they head, don't look for love now. The people only want bread, you feel my energy. First in your heart, then your head, when I say I come from under. That mean I walk with the dead, follow my ancestors. So I ain't never misled, study your bloodline. Cause they gon' tell it in red, I'm not your enemy. So why you plotting and scheming in the same vicinity? I'm in them streets that you be in, your cousin, my cousin, your brother, my brother, your sister, my sister. It's a thin line between the hustle and push up. We got the same grind, the same mind, the same struggle, same pain. What makes you think that I don't love you? We so cold, y'all. Let's get back in control, y'all. If he handling them business, you need to be getting involved at all. I make that music for them black folks. Nah, I make it for the ones who flat broke. Yeah, it one for you, you like the crack jokes. You only laugh because you lack hope. Yeah, I made that music for them black folks. Nah, I make it for the ones who flat broke. Yeah, it one for you, you like the crack jokes. You only laugh because you lack bittersweet memories. Painful thoughts in my head, bittersweet memories. I put that syrup on that bread when there wasn't nothing to eat. Pops, it was hard when you fled. My mama held it down. She told us, hold up our head. She said, by any means, make sure them babies get fed. Still got her body parts. But she gave her arm and a leg, talking about out the mud. Feet, knees, knuckles, then bled. Better set your pride aside. Make sure you borrow, don't beg. I know you feeling me. You probably been through the same. Ain't no convincing me. No race done been through our pain, but now that we hustling, now that we grinding, and now we gon' make it. We gon' pull through with or without reparation. We got the same grind, the same mind, the same struggle, same pain. What makes you think that I don't love you? We so cold, y'all. Let's get back in control, y'all. If he handling them business, you need to be getting involved at all. I make that music for them black folks. Nah, I make it for the ones who flat broke. Yeah, this one for you, you like the crack jokes. You only laugh because you lack hope. Yeah, I made that music for them black folks. Nah, I make it for the ones who flat broke. Yeah, this one for you, you like the crack jokes. You only laugh because you lack bittersweet memories. Yeah, you only laugh because you lack bittersweet memories. Yeah. I bet they laugh when they lack bittersweet memory. Yeah. They only laugh because they lack bittersweet memory.
Israel, get you a Bible, some pen and paper. Write these scriptures down, family, and study to show yourself approved. Let's go to Psalms 106. The book of Psalms 106. And I'm going to pick it up at verse 47. The book of Psalms, chapter 106. And your brother Kate Judah, go pick it up at verse 47. Psalms 106. And I'm going to pick it up at verse 47. And it reads, "Save us, O Lord, our God, and gather us from among the heathen." Read that again, K. Judah. "Save us, O Lord our God, and gather us from among the heathen, to give thanks unto thy holy name, and to triumph in thy praise. Blessed be the Lord God of Israel, from everlasting to everlasting. And let all the people say, Amen. Praise ye the Lord. This what you shall be saying, Israel. Save us, O Lord our God, and gather us from among the heathen. Because our people are going through some hard times, family. Hard times. And we shall pray to our God and seek him and ask him to save his people Israel out of the hand of those who hate us. Understand this, Israel. Let's go to Luke chapter 1. Because the Lord made a promise to our forefathers. Let's see what he said. Luke chapter 1. And I'm going to pick it up at verse 68. Luke chapter 1. And your brother Kate Judah, go pick it up at verse 68. Luke chapter 1. And I'm going to pick it up at verse 68. And it reads, Blessed be the Lord God of Israel. For he had visited and redeemed his people and had raised up a horn of salvation for us in the house of his servant David. We got to find out who is this horn that the Most High raised up to save us, to deliver us from oppression. Let's see, family. Let's go to Zechariah chapter 9. And I'm going to pick it up at verse 9. Who is this horn that the Most High set up and not man? Who is this horn, family? Let's go to Zechariah chapter 9. And I'm going to pick it up at verse 9. Zechariah chapter 9. And I'm going to pick it up at verse 9. Zechariah chapter 9 and verse 9. And it reads, Rejoice greatly, O daughter of Zion. Read that again, K. Judah. Rejoice greatly, O daughter of Zion. Shout, O daughter of Jerusalem. Behold, thy king cometh unto thee. For he is just and having salvation, lowly, and riding upon an ass, and upon the colt, the foal of an ass. Who is this that roll up on an ass in Jerusalem? Let's get this out of the mouth of two or three. We let it be established. Let's go to Matthew 21. The book of Matthew, chapter 21. And I'm going to pick it up at verse 1. Matthew, chapter 21. We got to find out who is this riding up on this ass, the colt, the foal of an ass. Matthew, chapter 21. And your brother, Kate Judah, go pick it up at verse 1. Matthew 21 and verse 1. And it reads, And when they drew nigh to Jerusalem and were come to Bethphage, unto the Mount of Olives, then sent Jesus two disciples, saying unto them, Go into the village over against you, and straightway ye shall find an ass tied, and the colt with her. Loose them and bring them unto me. And if any man say aught unto you, ye shall say, The Lord have need of them. Oh, now I got better understanding. Zechariah 9 verse 9 is talking about Yahshua HaMashiach. He's the one that came in Jerusalem on an ass, the colt, the foal of an ass, because all prophecy must be fulfilled. Understand this, Israel. Verse 2 again. Saying unto them, Go into a village over against you, and straightway ye shall find an ass tied, and a colt with her. Loose them, and bring them unto me. And if any man say aught unto you, ye shall say, The Lord have need of them. And straightway he will send them. All this was done. Read that again. All this was done, sweet to my lips. all this was done, that it might be fulfilled, which was spoken by the prophet, saying, tell ye the daughter of Zion, behold, thy king cometh unto thee, meek, and sitting upon an ass, and the colt, the foal of an ass. Oh, this is Yahshua, HaMashiach. So in Luke chapter 1, verse 68 and 69, when it said that the Most High have raised up a horn for us, he was talking about Yahshua, HaMashiach. Let's go back to Luke chapter 1. And this time, verse 68 again. Luke chapter 1. And I'm going to pick it back up at verse 68. Luke chapter 1. And your brother K. Judah, go pick it up at verse 68. And it reads, blessed be the Lord God of Israel, for he had visited and redeemed his people, and had raised up an horn of salvation for us in the house of his servant David, as he spake by the mouth of his holy prophets, which have been since the world began, that we should be saved. You better read that again. That we should be saved. Hold on, Zion. That we should be saved. Keep your faith intact. That we should be saved from our enemies, no, my friends, from our enemies and from the hand of all that hate us, to perform the mercy promised to our fathers and to remember his holy covenant, the oath which he swore to our father Abraham, that he would grant unto us, that we being delivered out of the hand of our enemies might serve him without fear. We ain't got long, Israel. It's closer than you think. We ain't got long, family. Behold your king. He coming, and he hasted greatly. Understand this, Israel. Let's go to Hosea chapter 5. Because one must ask himself, if the Lord want to deliver us, and he will, what must we do to be counted worthy to be in the gathering? Let's go to Hosea chapter 5. It's something we must do. Something that our people have a hard time understanding. Hosea chapter 5. Hosea chapter 5. And I'm going to pick it up at verse 15. Hosea chapter 5. And your brother K. Judah, go pick it up at verse 15. Hosea chapter 5 and verse 15. And it reads, I will go and return to my place to they acknowledge their offense and seek my face. What must we do? And seek my face. In their affliction, they will seek me early. And that's exactly what we doing, Israel. We are seeking him early. Many are waking up worldwide, and we are seeking him early. Understand this, family. But once we seek him, what he gonna do? Let's go to Deuteronomy chapter 30. Deuteronomy chapter 30. And I'm going to pick it up at verse 1. Deuteronomy chapter 30. And your brother K. Judah, go pick it up at verse 1. Deuteronomy 30 at verse 1. And it reads, and it shall come to pass, when all these things are come upon thee, the blessings and the curse which I have set before thee, and thou shalt call them to mind among all nations, whether the Lord thy God have driven thee, and shall return unto the Lord thy God, and shall obey his voice, according to all that I command thee this day, thou and thy children, with all thy heart and with all thy soul, that then the Lord thy God will turn thy captivity and have compassion upon thee, and will return and gather thee from all the nations, whether the Lord thy God have scattered thee. If any of thine be driven out unto the outmost parts of heaven, from this will the Lord thy God gather thee, and from thence will he fetch thee. And the Lord thy God will bring thee into the land which thy fathers possessed, and thou shalt possess it. And he will do thee good, and multiply thee above thy fathers. And the Lord thy God will circumcise thy heart, and the heart of thy seed, to love the Lord thy God with all thy heart and with all thy soul, that thou mayest live. Verse 7. And the Lord thy God will put all thee curses upon thy enemies. Read that again, Kate Judah. And the Lord thy God will put all thee curses upon thy enemies and on them that hate thee, which persecute thee. And thou shalt return and obey the voice of the Lord, and do all his commandments. I thought they was done away with. And do all his commandments, which I command thee this day. Talking about this day too. Verse 9. And the Lord thy God will make thee plenteous in every work of thy hand, in the fruit of thy body, and in the fruit of thy cattle, and in the fruit of thy land for good. For the Lord will again rejoice, and the Lord will again rejoice over thee for good, as he rejoiced over thy fathers, if thou shalt hearken unto the voice of the Lord thy God, to keep his commandments and his statutes, which are written in this book. What book? The book that's sitting on your shelf, collecting dust. Read verse 10 again. If thou shalt hearken unto the voice of the Lord thy God, to keep his commandments and his statutes, which are written in this book of the law, and if thou turn unto the Lord thy God with all thy heart and with all thy soul. So we gotta seek him, Israel. Then he will be found of us. If we seek him with the whole heart, meaning the whole mind and your soul. Understand this, family. But he said something. He said that he gave our fathers a land, a possession, an inheritance. What land is this? Let's go to Numbers chapter 34. Numbers chapter 34. And I'm going to pick it up at verse 1. Numbers chapter 34. And your brother Kate Judah, go pick it up at verse 1. What is this land that he gave unto our fathers for an inheritance forever? How long is forever? Forever. This is Numbers chapter 34. And I'm going to pick it up at verse 1. And it reads, and the Lord spake unto Moses, saying, command the children of Israel and say unto them, when ye come into the land of Canaan, read that again. When ye come into the land of Canaan, this is the land that shall fall unto you for an inheritance, even the land of Canaan with the coast thereof. Oh, so it's the land of Canaan that he swore unto our fathers. Let's get this out of the mouth of two or three. Let's go to Genesis chapter 17. Genesis. Because the Bible say that he swore unto our fathers and made a covenant with them. Genesis chapter 17. And I'm going to pick it up at verse 1. The book of Genesis. Chapter 17. And your brother K. Judah, go pick it up at verse 1. And it reads, and when Abram was 90 years old and 9, the Lord appeared to Abram and said unto him, I am the Almighty God. Walk before me and be thou perfect. And I will make my covenant between me and thee, and will multiply thee exceedingly. And Abram fell on his face, and God talked with him, saying, as for me, behold, my covenant is with thee, and thou shalt be a father of many nations. Neither shall thy name any more be called Abram, but thy name shall be Abraham. For a father of many nations have I made thee, and I will make thee exceedingly fruitful, and I will make nations of thee, and kings shall come out of thee. And I will establish my covenant, between me and thee, and thy seed after thee, in their generations, for an everlasting covenant. How long? For an everlasting covenant, to be a God unto thee, and to thy seed after thee. Verse 8, and I will give unto thee, and to thy seed after thee, the land wherein thou art a stranger, all the land of Canaan, for an everlasting possession. How long, K. Judah? For an everlasting possession, and I will be their God. So the land of Canaan is ours for an everlasting possession. So Israel, you have a home to go to. You have an inheritance. Understand this, family. This is not your resting place. You are soon to be delivered. You are soon to be gathered. And the Lord will bring you to Zion. Understand this, Israel. Let's go to Psalms 135. Where would the Lord be? If the Lord don't gather us, where will Yahshua HaMashiach be? Because a lot of you believe you're going to heaven. Let me show you that Yahshua HaMashiach will be wherever his people at. And since we don't go to heaven when we die, and we will rule on the earth, that means Yahshua HaMashiach will be in the midst of Israel on the earth in Zion. How we know that? Psalms 135. And I'm going to pick it up at verse 19. Psalms 135. And your brother K. Judah, go pick it up at verse 19. Psalms 135 and 19. And it reads, bless the Lord, O house of Israel. Bless the Lord, O house of Aaron. Bless the Lord, O house of Levi. Ye that fear the Lord, bless the Lord. Blessed be the Lord out of Zion. Read that again. Blessed be the Lord out of Zion, sweet to my lips. Blessed be the Lord out of Zion, which dwelleth at Jerusalem. Where would the Lord be? Which dwelleth at Jerusalem. Praise ye the Lord. So the Lord will be at Jerusalem, which is Mount Zion. So do you see that the Lord is not taking you to heaven? Many Christians believe when they die, they go to heaven, or believe you're going to be raptured off to heaven. But the Bible just told us that the Lord will dwell at Zion, Jerusalem. Understand this, Israel. Let's get this out of the mouth of two or three. We let it be established. Let's go to Psalm 76. Psalms 76. And I'm going to read one verse. Verse 2. Psalms 76. And your brother K. Judah, going to read one verse. Psalm 76. And verse 2, and it reads, in Salem also is his tabernacle, and his dwelling place in Zion. Read that again. In Salem, meaning Jerusalem, also his tabernacle, and his dwelling place in Zion. So the Lord's dwelling place is Zion. The Lord wants to dwell in Zion. He will be here on the earth, and his kingdom will be established on the earth. How we know that? Let's go to Daniel chapter 7. The book of Daniel. Chapter 7. And I'm going to pick it up at verse 13. Daniel. Chapter 7. And I'm going to pick it up at verse 13. Daniel chapter 7 and verse 13. And it reads, I saw in the night vision, and behold, one like the Son of Man came with the clouds of heaven, and came to the Ancient of Days. And they brought him near before him, and there was given him dominion and glory and a kingdom, that all people, nations, and languages should serve him. His dominion is an everlasting dominion which should not pass away, and his kingdom that which should not be destroyed. Jump down to verse 18. 18, and it reads, but the saints of the Most High shall take the kingdom and possess the kingdom forever, even forever and ever. Now let me show you that the kingdom will be on the earth. Jump down to verse 27. Verse 27. And it reads, and the kingdom and dominion and the greatness of the kingdom under, no, we go to heaven when we die. Under, okay, Judah, we go to heaven when we die. Let me read that again from the top. And the kingdom and dominion and the greatness of the kingdom under the whole heaven should be given to the people of the saints of the Most High, whose kingdom is an everlasting kingdom, and all dominion should serve and obey him. Did you hear that? Under the whole heaven. What is under, family? Meaning under where the Father, the angels, and Christ dwell now. Under the whole heaven. That means Christ will be here on the earth. Understand this, man. This is his desire. Don't you know this is Christ's desire to dwell with his people? He wants to be in Zion. How we know that? Let's go to Psalms 132. Psalms 132. And I'm going to pick it up at verse 13. Christ wants to dwell in Zion. Psalms 132. And I'm going to pick it up at verse 13. Psalms 132. And your brother K. Judah, go pick it up at verse 13. Psalms 132 and verse 13. And it reads, for the Lord have chosen Zion. He have desired it for his habitation. What is your habitation? Where you live at? Let me read that again. For the Lord have chosen Zion. He have desired it for his habitation. This is my rest forever. Here will I dwell, for I have desired it. Did you hear that? Let me read verse 14 again, just in case somebody did not get it. This is my rest forever. Here will I dwell, for I have desired it. So the Lord is telling you, I have desired to dwell in Zion with my people. He tried to dwell with our fathers in the wilderness. That's why he told Moses to build a tabernacle, because the Lord came above the mercy seat and he was in the midst of Israel. But they ran the Lord off the earth. This time, we're not running the Lord off the earth. He's going to run us off the earth with that sword. Understand this, Israel. So the Lord's desire is to dwell in the midst of his people. He have desired this. He want to live in Zion. This is his habitation. Understand this, family. Let's go to Zephaniah chapter 3. Zephaniah. The Lord is going to bring you to Zion. Zephaniah chapter 3. Zephaniah chapter 3. And I'm going to pick it up at verse 19. Zephaniah chapter 3. And I'm going to pick it up at verse 19. And it reads, behold, at that time I will undo all that afflict thee. All. How absolute is all that afflict thee? Let me read that again. Behold, at that time, I will undo all that afflict thee, and I will save her that halted, and gathered her that was driven out, and I will get thee, and I will get them praise and fame in every land where they have been put to shame. At that time, I will bring you again, even in the time that I gather you, for I will make you a name and a praise among all people of the earth. When I turn back your captivity before your eyes, said the Lord. And I can't wait to see that day. I don't even know what that feel like, to have a name and praise among all the nations. Because now we are only despised. Now we are only mocked. Now we full of sorrow and grief and anguish and pain and tears. So we don't know what that feel like. But at that day, the Lord will give us a name and praise among all that afflicted us. Understand this, heathens. Understand this. Let's go to Joel chapter 3. Joel chapter 3. And I'm going to pick it up at verse 16. Joel chapter 3. And I'm going to pick it up at verse 16. Joel chapter 3. And I'm going to pick it up at verse 16. And it reads, the Lord also shall roar out of Zion. Where the Lord going to roar from? The Lord also shall roar out of Zion and utter his voice from Jerusalem, and the heavens and the earth shall shake. But the Lord will be the hope of his people and the strength of the children of Israel. So shall ye know that I am the Lord your God, dwelling in Zion. Read that again, K. Judah. So shall ye know that I am the Lord your God, dwelling in Zion, my holy mountain. Then shall Jerusalem be holy, and there shall no strangers pass through her anymore. And it shall come to pass in that day that the mountain shall drop down new wine, and the hills shall flow with milk, and all the rivers of Judah shall flow with water, and a fountain shall come forth of the house of the Lord, and shall water the valley of Shittim. Egypt shall be a desolation, what you did to us. Egypt shall be a desolation, and Edom for your hatred shall be a desolate wilderness for the violence against the children of Judah. Read that again. For the violence against the children of Judah. You ain't getting away with that. For the violence against the children of Judah. Because they have shed innocent blood in their land. But Judah shall dwell forever. And Jerusalem from generation to generation. For I will cleanse their blood that I have not cleansed. For the Lord dwelleth in Zion. For the Lord dwelleth in Zion. So do you see that Yahshua HaMashiach will dwell in Zion, and he will gather you, Israel? How we know that? Isaiah 52. And I'm going to pick it up at verse 1. Isaiah 52. And I'm going to pick it up at verse 1. Isaiah chapter 52. And your brother K. Judah, don't pick it up at verse 1. Isaiah 52 and verse 1. And it reads, awake, awake, put on thy strength, O Zion. Put on thy beautiful garments, O Jerusalem, the holy city. From henceforth, there shall no more come into thee the uncircumcised and the unclean. Shake thyself from the dust. Arise and sit down, O Jerusalem. Loose thyself from the bands of thy neck, O captain daughter of Zion. Do you see? Loose the bands on your mind. Loose the bands on your mind, your captivity. Come back to your God and come out of her, my people, and loose the bands that is on your mind. Understand this, Israel. Verse 2 again. Shake thyself from the dust. Arise and sit down, O Jerusalem. Loose thyself from the bands of thy neck, O captain, daughter of Zion. Jump down to verse 6. Verse 6. And it reads, therefore, my people should know my name. Therefore, they should know in that day that I am he that do speak. Behold, it is I. How beautiful upon the mountain are the feet of him that bringeth good tidings, that publish peace, that bringeth good tidings of good, that publish salvation, that said unto Zion, thy God reigneth. Read that again. That say unto Zion, thy God reigneth. Sweet to my lips. That say unto Zion, thy God reigneth. And where will he reign from? From Jerusalem, the real Mount Zion. Understand this, Israel. Let's go to Micah chapter 4. Micah chapter 4. And I'm going to pick it up at verse 6. Micah chapter 4. And your brother K. Judah, go pick it up at verse 6. Micah chapter 4. And verse 6. And it reads, in that day, said the Lord, I will assemble her that halted. I will gather her that was driven out, and her that I have afflicted. And I will make her that halted a remnant, and her that was cast far off a strong nation. And the Lord shall reign. Read that again. And the Lord shall reign over them in Mount Zion, from henceforth, even forever. And thou, O tower of the flock. Who is the tower of the flock? Yahshua HaMashiach. And thou, O tower of the flock, the stronghold of the daughter of Zion. Unto thee shall it come, even the first dominion. The kingdom shall come to the daughter of Jerusalem. So just hold on, Israel. The kingdom is coming to you. Hold on in your faith, Israel. The kingdom is coming to you. Understand this, family. Verse 9. Now why doest thou cry aloud? Is there no king in thee? Is thy counselor perished? For pains have taken thee as a woman in travail. Be in pain and labor to bring forth, O daughter of Zion, like a woman in travail. And we have been travailing like a woman. Y'all better talk to me. We have been in pain, travailing like a woman, Zion. For all the things that we have been through, it's been like a woman travailing in pain. Verse 10 again. Be in pain and labor to bring forth, O daughter of Zion, like a woman in travail. For now should thou go forth out of the city, and thou should dwell in the field, and thou should go even to Babylon. There should thou be delivered. There the Lord shall redeem thee from the hand of thy enemies. Now also many nations are gathered against thee. They say, let her be defiled, and let our eyes look upon Zion. But they know not the thoughts of the Lord, neither understand they his counsel. For he shall gather them as the sheaves into the floor. Arise and thrust, O daughter of Zion, for I will make thy horn iron, and I will make thy hoofs brass, and thou shalt beat in pieces many people. I will consecrate their gain unto the Lord, and their substance unto the Lord of the whole earth. So do you see that this should give you joy? This should give you joy that you are about to go home, that you are about to be delivered, never to be in captivity again, but to serve your power in Zion. Understand this, Israel. Let's go to Psalms 78. Why did the Lord choose Zion out of all the tribes of Israel? Let's go to Psalms 78. Psalms 78. And I'm going to pick it up at verse 65. Psalms 78. And I'm going to pick it up at verse 65. Psalm 78 and verse 65. And it reads, "Then the Lord awake as one out of sleep, and like a mighty man that shouted by reason of wine. And he smote his enemies in the hinder parts. He put them to a perpetual reproach. Moreover, he refused the tabernacle of Joseph and chose not the tribe of Ephraim, but chose the tribe of Judah, the Mount Zion." Read that again, K. Judah. "But chose the tribe of Judah, the Mount Zion." You better read that again. "But he chose the tribe of Judah, the Mount Zion, which he loved. And he built his sanctuary like his palaces, like the earth which he had established forever." The Lord loved Zion. Why did the Lord choose the tribe of Judah? Let's go to Hebrews chapter 7. Hebrews. Woo, this is sweet to my lips. Why did the Lord choose the tribe of Judah? Let's see. Hebrews chapter 7. And I'm going to read one verse. Verse 14. Hebrews chapter 7. And your brother K. Judah going to read one verse. Verse 14. Hebrews chapter 7 and verse 14. And it reads, "For it is evident that our Lord sprang out of Judah." Read that again. "For it is evident that our Lord sprang out of Judah, of which tribe Moses spake nothing concerning priesthood." Why? Because Levi was the priest. "But we know according to the order of Melchizedek, Christ is the high priest." What do a priest do? They are a mediator. Moses was the mediator. Levi was the mediator. And Christ is on the right-hand side of the Most High, Melchizedek, the high priest, being the mediator between us and our Father. Understand this, Israel. Let's go to Isaiah chapter 46. Isaiah. Because now we understand why he chose the tribe of Judah. Because the Lord sprang out of Judah. Isaiah 46. And I'm going to pick it up at verse 3. Isaiah 46. And I'm going to pick it up at verse 3. The book of Isaiah, chapter 46. And your brother K. Judah, don't pick it up at verse 3. And it reads, "Hearken unto me, O house of Jacob, and all the remnant of the house of Israel, which are born by me from the belly, which are carried from the womb, and even to your old age am he, and even to the hoary hairs will I carry you. I have made, and I will bear, even I will carry, and I will deliver you." Do you see this? "And the Lord will deliver you." Jump down to verse 13. Verse 13. And it reads, "I bring near my righteousness. It should not be far off. And my salvation should not tarry. I will place salvation in Zion." Read that again. "And I will place salvation in Zion for Israel, my glory." So the Lord is letting it be known that when he come back, when heaven roll back as a scroll, the Lord will be with his people in Mount Zion. That's his habitation. He have desired it. He chose the tribe of Judah and Jerusalem, which is Mount Zion. Let's go to Psalms 87. Psalms. The Lord loves Zion more than all the tribes. He loves Zion. Psalms 87. Psalms 87 and verse 1. Psalms 87 and verse 1. Psalms 87 and verse 1. And it reads, "His foundations is in the holy mountains. The Lord loveth the gates of Zion more than all the dwellings of Jacob. You better read that again. The Lord loveth the gates of Zion more than all the dwellings of Jacob. Sweet to my lips. The Lord loveth the gates of Zion more than all the dwellings of Jacob. So do you see that the Lord want to dwell with you bad, Israel? And he will dwell with you when he come back. When he come back, family. Let's go to Psalms 102. Psalms 102. Because the Lord will have mercy on you, Israel. Oh, yeah, it's coming. The Lord will gather you and have mercy on you and multiply you above your fathers. Psalms 102. And verse 12, Psalms 102, and your brother K. Judah, gon' pick it up at verse 12. And it reads, but thou, O Lord, shall endure forever, and thy remembrance unto all generations. Thou shalt rise and have mercy upon Zion, for the time to favor her, yea, the set time is come. For thy servants take pledge in her stones and favor the dust thereof. So the heathen shall fear the name of the Lord and all the kings of the earth thy glory. When the Lord shall build up Zion, he shall appear in his glory. You better read that again. When the Lord shall build up Zion, he shall appear in his glory. Like my brother Kenley Yours like to tell me. Read it again, Negro. When the Lord shall build up Zion, he shall appear in his glory. He will regard the prayer of the destitute and not despise their prayers. And the Lord been hearing our prayers, Israel. You better believe it. The Lord been hearing our prayers. And he is fighting on our behalf. Understand this, Israel. Let's go to Jeremiah chapter 30. Jeremiah chapter 30. Because the time has come to restore health unto you. The time has come to restore health unto you. Jeremiah 30. And I'm going to pick it up at verse 16. Jeremiah chapter 30. And your brother K. Judah, go pick it up at verse 16. Jeremiah 30 and verse 16. And it reads, therefore, all that devour thee shall be devoured, and all thy adversaries, every one of them, shall go into captivity. And they that spoil thee shall be a spoil, and all that prey upon thee will I give for a prey. And I will restore health unto thee, and I will heal thee of thy wounds, saith the Lord. Because they call thee an outcast, saying, this is Zion, whom no man seeketh after. Thus saith the Lord, behold, I will bring again the captivity of Jacob's tents and have mercy on his dwelling places. And the city shall be built upon her own heap, and the palaces shall remain after the manner thereof. And out of them shall proceed thanksgivings and the voice of them that make merry. And I will multiply them, and they shall not be few. I will also glorify them, and they shall not be small. Their children also shall be as aforetime, and their children also shall be as aforetime, and their congregation shall be established before me, and I will punish all that oppress them, and their nobles shall be of themselves, and their governor shall proceed from the midst of them, and I will cause him to draw near, and he shall approach unto me. For who is this that engage in his heart to approach unto me, said the Lord? And ye shall be my people, and I will be your God. So it's coming, family. Behold the king. He's coming. Let's go to Isaiah 27. Isaiah chapter 27. And I'm going to pick it up at verse 12. Isaiah 27. Behold your king, Israel. He coming. And it hasted greatly. Isaiah 27, and your brother K. Judah, don't pick it up at verse 12. Isaiah 27. And I'm going to pick it up at verse 12. And it reads, and it shall come to pass in that day that the Lord shall beat off from the channel of the river unto the stream of Egypt. And ye shall be gathered one by one, O children of Israel. And it shall come to pass in that day that the great trumpet shall be blown, and they shall come which was ready to perish in the land of Assyria, and the outcast in the land of Egypt, and shall worship the Lord in the holy mount at Jerusalem, which is Mount Zion. So the Lord say he gonna gather us one by one. Let's go to Isaiah 11, 11. Isaiah 11, 11. Isaiah chapter 11, verse 11. And this she encourage you. Isaiah chapter 11. And I'm going to pick it up at verse 11. The nine tribes are in Africa. They did not come here on the slave ships. Let me say that again. The nine tribes, or some say ten, because the son of Levi is still over there, and son of Levi came over here with us. So I'm going to say nine, because three came over here, and nine is left in Africa. So the nine tribes never came to this side of the pond. So let's see what God is going to gather the nine tribes from. Isaiah chapter 11, verse 11. And it reads, and it shall come to pass in that day that the Lord shall set his hand again a second time to recover the remnant of his people, which should be left from Assyria, black nation, and from Egypt, black nation, from Pathros, black nation, and from Cush, the Ethiopians, and from Elam, and from Shinar, black nation, and from Hamath, black nation, and from the islands of the sea. And he shall set up an ensign for the nations, and shall assemble the outcasts of Israel, and gather together, then he got around to us, and gather together the dispersed of Judah from the four corners of the earth. So do you see that the nine tribes was not scattered to the four corners of the earth, but Judah, Benjamin, and some of Levi were scattered to the four corners of the earth. So he gonna gather the nine tribes from Africa, and Judah, Benjamin, and some of Levi from the four corners of the earth. Understand this, Israel. The Lord will gather you. All you have to do is keep your faith. That's it. Let's go to Jeremiah chapter 3. Jeremiah chapter 3. And I want y'all to know that this was all the Old Testament. But you have people that don't believe in the Old Testament. So I just use a few scriptures in the New. And majority of this whole lesson was in the Old Testament, how the Lord gonna gather us in that day. It has not happened yet. So this whole Bible, Christ come in the volume of the whole Bible. You need this whole Bible to get understanding. Not one part of a book. Jeremiah chapter 3. And I'm gonna only read one verse. Verse 14. Jeremiah chapter 3. And your brother K. Judah gonna read one verse, verse 14. And it reads, turn, O backsliding children, said the Lord, for I am married unto you, and I will take you one of a city and two of a family, and I will bring you to Zion. When would this happen? When would this take place? When would this happen? Let's go to Matthew 24. Matthew, when would the Lord gather us? Matthew 24. And I'm going to pick it up at verse 29. Matthew 24. And your brother K. Judah, gonna pick it up at verse 29. Matthew 24 and verse 29. And it reads, immediately after the tribulation of those days, should the sun be darkened, and the moon should not give her light, and the stars shall fall from heaven, and the powers of the heavens shall be shaken, and then shall appear the sign of the Son of Man in heaven. And then shall the tribes of the earth mourn, and they shall see the Son of Man coming in the clouds of heaven with power and great glory. And he shall send his angels with a great sound of a trumpet. Read that again. And he shall send his angels with a great sound of a trumpet. And they shall gather together his elect from the four winds, from one end of heaven to the other. So do you see that we would not be gathered until after the tribulation of those days, until after the great tribulation of those days? Then shall appear the sign of the Son of Man, and he going to send his angels to gather us, one of a city and two of a family. And the Lord going to bring us to Zion, and your brother Kate Judah want to say shalom.
Hi, I'm Molly Music. The name of this song is called Ready Aim, and this is R&B Sessions. I'm on an airplane, and the destination of this flight is to the other side. Yeah, guess I had to go there. Guess I had to come here. I know where I'm from, but now I'm headed where I'm going, right? Powers in the air, you can see them, and they have rockets and machine guns, and they're firing on my plane. But I say fire, fire, hey, ready, aim, fire, yeah. You can't shoot me down. Oh, fire, hey, fire, yeah. Ready, aim, fire, hey. You can't stop me now. Can't stop me now, no. La 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 la. Oh. I'm on a rocket ship, and the destination of this rocket is to outer space. Alright. I don't know, but I guess I had to go. Guess I had to come here, yeah. I'm from the earth, but I've been taken to another place. I've been taken to another space. And there are powers even there, but you can't see them. And they have rockets and machine guns, hey. And they're firing on my brain. I say fire, fire, hey, oh, ready, aim, fire. You can't shoot me down. Oh, fire, hey, bang, fire, ready, aim, fire. Hey, you can't stop. Can't stop me now, no. Hey. All right. Just tryna make it straight, cause it's sideways. Tryna take water to a dry place. Tryna take court where it ain't none. Tryna bang low to a high place. I don't wanna make the shooter put the gun down. So mother gets a hold of her now. Wanna make the lame man run again. Make the blind man see the sun again. But all I hear is bang bang yet. I don't think the pounds really want that. Breathing down my neck, always on my back. Got the guns up, but I say, shoot me down, by you. Hey, fire, ready, aim, fire. Hey, you can't stop me now. Oh, fire, fire. Hey. Can't stop me now, no. God. Already gone. Already here.
And thistles it shall bring forth for us. For out of the ground we were taken, for the dust we are, and to the dust we shall return.